we've got a race to... What?
So the red's off.
So congratulations to the two guys who made the final. Race to 11. Come and enjoy the show, because I know that you won't be waiting for them. They're very fast players. And good luck to both players.
You and two Rickies. Depending on which one we try and watch.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Australian Oceania 2016 10 Ball Championships. And have we got a mouthwatering prospect for you tonight? We've got Mr. Sean Budd on the left, and the young, dashingly good-looking, charming Vinny Calabrese on the right-hand side. You're joined by Barry the Mule Mavros, that's me, hello everybody, and the lovely Gavin Douglas. Douglas, how are you going?
I'm very excited, Barry. It should be a very good match.
I think so too. Honestly, we had the two biggest firecrackers in the final. Two big guns. Orders. Big guns. They've been playing fantastic all day long. Sean Budd qualified first in all the group, above everybody else. He had the highest for and against. And Vinny Calabrese found another gear today. Just couldn't miss a ball at one stage.
Well, he was 6-1 down in the semi.
Yes, he was.
Well, and Sean was 3-0 down in the other semi. And they just fired up. Here we have the equally handsome James Georgiadis.
Thanks, mate. How you going, Gavin? All right?
Very good, thank you.
Barry, the Gundiskalizer?
I'm very well, thank you for asking. Super excited about this match. Can't wait. So sit back at home, guys, get some popcorn, grab open a bottle of whiskey, and drink quick, because these guys are fast players. Should be super exciting. Sean has won the lag and he's ready to start off this final. Good luck to both gentlemen. Sean's not known for being a really great breaker, but he has been breaking pretty well all day. What's Sean?
Push out here. Where's he going to push to, Barry? Or can he nick it?
Well, I'm not sure. From our angle here, I don't even know if you can see the edge of the ball. For this final, I mean, Sean's been very steady all day long. And with Vinny, he's had moments where he's had that little dip. You know what I mean? He's been dipping a little bit and then just turning it right on. So I'd like to see what happens throughout this final, if they're going to keep it up the whole way through.
Two very different styles, for sure.
Ultra-aggressive. Oh, my goodness. You know, I love Sean, but I also hate him at the same time, because he just does stuff like that
all
the time.
Makes it look too easy.
Too easy.
It's not that easy. The table looks small on the screen, but it's actually quite a big table.
He's made a meal of that one.
Commentator's curse.
He likes to lift his collar up when he plays. I noticed when he did that in the first round when he was behind. He's down in the first round, ladies and gentlemen, today. He was losing 7-3 in a race to 8 to a young fellow, I don't remember his name. And then he put his collar up and he just ran 5. That's something to do with aerodynamics when you get down the shot. A kick shot, I think he'll be happy with that. He'll be very happy with that.
Yeah,
it's a great kick shot. Now, first chance to see Vinny Calabrese play. I want to send a very big special shout out at the moment to Dan Lynch for letting us commentate on the final tonight and for bringing you all at home Cueball TV. Another very big special shout out to my man Kimpton Chris, who's at home watching at the moment. Hello, my man.
He's making me some shirts for my business too, Kimpton. If anyone needs some shirts made, does a fantastic job.
You get $10 every time you say it, don't you?
No, but I should get $10 off, surely.
Well, that's a mistake there from Vinny. Really should be nowhere near that pocket, but Budman has got a ball in hand, and from what I've seen all day long today, he's favourite to run the rack out. This is a man that's won multiple championships in every single discipline there is to offer in the whole country. He's won everything, this guy.
Would he be the only one to win all of them, do you reckon? Two shot, snooker. That's
a good question.
Nine ball, 10 ball, 8 ball?
That's a good question. Maybe the viewers at home can help us out here.
I can't think of, maybe, well, Noonan wouldn't have won the Australian snooker, but he would have won everything else. Not sure.
Bud is definitely the player that's won the most titles out of anyone in the country. Still a force in pool, three decades later.
Maybe Lawler? Would Lawler play two shot?
I'm not sure. I saw Sean Budd play a year ago. He wasn't playing that great.
In the Scotch doubles last year for the World Cup, he didn't play very well at all, but I think he wasn't playing any snooker at the time either.
And then so something's changed since then, because the last two times I've seen him play...
He's remembered that he's the best.
He's a machine again. He's remembered. He's remembered.
Everything's plain ball. Look at that. Perfect.
But you know what makes him such a great player. We all know what makes him such a great player. Tell me.
Talent?
It's this fantastic cue action. Look at this cue
action.
Oh,
the grip, everything. You've got him again, Baz. You've got him a beauty.
Oh, my God.
That's enough. Barry, you're off the commentary team.
I've seen it all, ladies and gentlemen. I haven't seen Sean miss a ball like that all day. I know, maybe just took it for granted. It was just an easy shot. All right, 1-0. This is an easy game. Don't put any balls and you win the frame.
Yeah. That's all I like to play.
Is this the angle that the people at home can see? Ladies and gentlemen, have a look at the venue. If you've never been down to South Australia, come down, play in one of our tournaments. The Empire is the best pool hall in the country to play pool. Hosted by Alec Averniadis, does a fantastic job every year, taking care of all the interstate players and everybody here. Recloths his tables, everything's in good condition. Great quality pool. Great place to play pool. Vinny's been breaking well all day. He's been breaking well. He's been breaking better than Sean.
Not an easy run out. Probably put the one and the three and maybe play safe. 1-3-9.
For me, this match, it's a question mark for me about Vinny, how Vinny will play. Like I said, if he can keep his focus up.
He could blow away.
We all know that he's amazing. We all know he's amazing. And trust me, I'm Vinny's biggest fan. But can he sustain it the whole way through? Because, honestly, there is a big Bud intimidation factor that people don't talk about.
People fall apart.
All day long, I've seen people, great players, come up against Bud.
This is dangerous.
And just lose it. Can Vinny...
Yeah, that's dangerous.
...keep his cool together? I know, it's not a good shot.
Yeah.
And that it's true, he's very intimidating.
Of course, he's the best player we have.
Not only does he play fantastic, but I just noticed a lot of players that play against him, Gav, don't play as good as they normally play.
No.
I mean, playing a living legend of the sport. And I believe we're seeing the new living legend right here, the young Vinny Calabrese. Now, from our Canberra angle, I don't believe it's possible, but if it is, this man will not shy away from a pot.
I think it might be a two-rail safety. Oh, that's not the best.
It's the longest shot. But he can attack here.
And he will. He will attack.
No. I'll tell you what, you're really calling him today, Gavin.
He's on fire. There.
He's on fire.
Watching his semi, he was trying to take on everything.
Yeah, but it's different. It's a different game. You know, this game is so fickle. The momentum can shift with one bad shot. And you don't want to give Bard a sniff at anything.
That's a quality shot there.
He's got that killer instinct on the table.
Bud?
Bud, definitely, of course, Bud. Definitely. He's got that killer instinct. When he sniffs a bit of weakness, he just goes through the jugular.
Yeah.
Has this got the legs? It hasn't got the legs. It's going to be ball in hand.
It's going to be.
It's not good at all. What a final. We also have the nine ball, Oceania nine ball, to be played tomorrow and the day after as
what
well.
What about the women's final we just watched? Probably the best women's final I've ever
seen. We have to talk about
probably
that.
Probably the best women's game I've ever seen.
The best women's final ever. It was Mulrood.
9-8 or 8-7, whatever. What was the first of
all? Mulrood versus Bean.
Bean.
Mulrood from New Zealand versus Bean from, I'm not sure where she's from.
She lives in Queensland, but I think she's from Taipei originally. But that is the first six frames, there was four or five runouts.
Definitely the best women's final I've seen in a long time.
We all love Jenny Budd because she rocks. She's strangling me to say that at this present moment.
It's a real position shot coming here from Budd, bottom left. Two. See, from here I can no call kiss. Anything. I can no do anything kiss. From here.
Yeah, it's easy.
But executing on the table is a different story. Again.
No, perfect.
That's good.
It was close.
One apiece.
Barry hasn't said anything on that 10. I want to make sure
I didn't want to
first.
Say anything this time around, dude. It's been a long time since there's some commentary. Kind of miss it.
Were you
it.
Here last time with the Australian teams? Did you do it then?
I couldn't. I was very ill that day.
No, that's right.
Yeah. I was asked
you
to,
had
but
the flu
I was
all week.
I was very sick the last tournament. I could barely speak. So I decided not to. I have missed it. I've missed everybody here. You know, I took a break from the game for a while, and it's just good to see everybody again.
Oh, it's a fun week. It's a fun week.
Yes, we missed Jenny.
We missed you when you were over there. We don't miss you so much now when you're over here.
Oh, yes, I've been reminded to mention that we have got two New South Walesmen in the final. Pool is not dominated by South Australians, according to a certain individual, George Mergulis, I believe, says that South Australians keep dominating. And I just want you to know that $1,000 that I won off you a little while ago, George, went to the bar tab. And well, everyone's very thankful.
Beautiful.
Thank you very much.
Thanks,
George.
Georgie.
We all appreciate the drinks.
We even coined a term. Hopefully I'll get to use it later in commentary.
Early indications for me, Sean is looking very steady. Very steady. He's been in so many finals. He knows how to win matches. He knows how to win tournaments. He knows how to close. Vinny has been away for a while and he's starting to find some good form. Definitely the most talented player I've ever seen. Well,
actually, playing well for with one eye.
One eye, yeah.
One eye at the moment. Wouldn't want to play him when he has two eyes.
Going to come up with a good safety shot here. He thinks really quick, this young man.
Definitely.
One, two. Yeah. I think it's going to stick its head out. I can't see. Yeah, it stuck its head out. These tables are just re-clothed with Andy 900 cloth.
I thought these four along here are beautiful.
And they're like glass.
Beautiful
they're
tables.
Really quick tables. I've never played anything like them before. Lightning. Very hard to control the ball. These young men make it look easy. Bud steadying himself. Bottom right, two rails. One. Oh no. Safety shot. See, ooh, this is the thing with this guy,
what
man.
A shot.
He
what
just
a shot.
Plays the right shots at the right time. He's not going to risk anything. He's got that bit between his teeth and he wants to keep it there. And it's going to pay some dividends, that safety shot. He's got a shot on the one with angle to get himself on the two. And again, Buddy's first in. This is the third frame in a row, by the way, Buddy's first in. And yeah, this is what I was saying earlier before the match, that Bud has the ability to outfox the fox. He's cunning on the table. Yeah, his safety plays, he's cunning. You get involved with safety battles with this guy.
And playing,
you know you're not favourite to beat him.
No, that's right.
Not only is the probably the best talented QS we've ever had in the country, not only is he the most experienced player in the room, but he's a smart person. Very knowledgeable. All about getting on that five ball now. He gets on this five ball plum, he's going to run the rack. And
this is the shot.
He's there. No, it's good. Shot like this for sure is like it's over the pocket.
Yeah.
Snooker background, he's not missing this.
Man, you've got him again. That's it, bro.
You know what?
Fair dinkum.
I could bring down an airplane with my comments today.
Please. Saying that when you were playing? I won't miss this one.
But look at this. He's got second prize at least.
You think he can't hit?
I can't believe Bud missed that shot. He did. He was nailing shots like that all day long. He even apologized. What a gentleman. He even apologized for snookering Vinny.
Oh. Murderer. He's got away with it there.
Then he says sorry again the second time. Puts his hand up. He's not really sorry, though. No. He's happy.
He's not going to lose. I'm not really sorry. That's for sure.
Bud, you're lying. You're not really sorry.
If you're that sorry, just pick it up and give it to him.
Okay, ball in hand. Surely Bud's out. I tell you what, though. Look where he put the white ball. He's not controlling his rock as well as he normally does.
He'll play behind the seven, play the seven up the top.
I think he's a stun over one rail. Yep.
Oh, what a shot.
Yeah, the reason why he's just maybe overrunning a shot a foot is because, like I said, the clock is lightning speed.
And he didn't play on this table before, did he, the semi? He played up the other end.
They played on the other table. They're pretty similar. Love how he works the angles. And he is looking good to go 2-1. And I tell you what, I know it's 2-1, and the score does flatter Vinny here because it really has been Sean
it
so far.
Three.
The whole,
he missed the 10.
It should be 3-0, yeah. I haven't seen Vinny step it up yet.
No, and but if someone is going to rattle off 5 frames in 5 minutes, it's going to be Vinny.
Oh, no doubt. He did that last match. But if the table is breaking easy and it's an open table, then for me it's still even money. But if it's not breaking well and there's a lot of safety play, I have to put Sean favourite in this particular match. I have to.
Well,
Sean's safety plays.
Vinny's been playing since he was, I don't even know, five. So he's seen it all as well. The best final I've ever seen was between these two at Mounties one year.
Yeah, but Vinny's more of a rhythm type of player. He gets that gear going. If someone starts to break up his flow, like a Robbie Fulvari, for example, breaks up his rhythm, breaks up his flow, lots of safety play, you know. Or a Ricky Watson, for example, he got him last time in the last tournament. Again, safety play, slower rhythm player. Of course, Sean's a quick player, but Sean can play quick, slow, safety battles, you name it. Sean's got no limitations in that area.
No.
I think Vinny has to run a couple of racks now, double time quick, punch Sean back, catch Sean thinking, hey, this kid can beat me. Because Sean, in his mind, honest, I know Sean, in his mind, he believes his favourite any match he plays. Can you think of one person to say no to in a money match?
No. Well, I know a few that he said yes to.
Yeah, but he wouldn't say no to anyone. I don't think so.
No.
And I believe you have to be like that. You have to believe your favourite.
You can't be walking the match thinking,
oh, this guy's favourite.
You can't be scared. You got to take it on.
That's what makes him such a great player. And the fact is so good. Right, decision time here for Sean. What's he going to do with this white ball? Obviously, he's not going to attack here. He's going to push out.
I was going to say hello to my dad, Barry, who just tuned in to watch. Love you, Dad. Hope you're looking after my boy. Hope he's being a good boy, eating you out of house and home.
So even though Bud can see a full ball here, he still opted to push. And
there's a plan behind the push. He's hoping to get sent back in, I think.
I know, sorry, they're on the one ball. Sorry, I thought it was on the two. My apologies, guys. Yeah, Finney's not going to shy away from a shot. We know this. We know he's not going to shy away from a shot, but what's going to happen?
How many balls got in there? Did the 10 go in there?
He's going to make every ball and still going to stay off with 102.
Oh, the two's there. Oh.
And I think this is going to be okay.
It's going
to... I think it's... No. No, it's not.
Still, he's got a hole for the five, and that's definitely not easy.
He's going to play the kiss into the five. Yeah, he's going to... Yeah. I believe he will.
This drag that he plays, I think, is better than anyone.
Anyone in the country. Ben Noonan also plays a good drag shot. We used to. What a great shot.
If that's in the middle, he's... If he can snip it in, it's easy. If he can't, it's definitely not easy.
Gotta love watching this guy play. Oh, wow. He's butchered one. I believe Vinny has to fire here. Vinny has to make something happen.
It'll be all
out attack. He has to. Oh. That's Vinny's first chance to play, yeah. This is what Vinny's got to do. He's going to just run racks against him. Just keep running racks against him, because Vinny makes the game look ridiculously easy.
This frame won't be lasting 2 minutes.
I don't think there's anyone in the country that makes a frame look as easy as Vinny does. He makes He makes pool look like it's a simple game.
100%.
I'm so happy I'm commentating this match. This is a brilliant match. This is so awesome. Double time, two apiece. This is what I want to see. Well done, Vinny. Well done, young man.
Two all.
I want to send out a big special hello to the Under the Bus Sexy Honey crew. Oh, all the boys out there, you know who you are, for supporting the young man here at the table, Vinny Calabrese. And
Charlie.
I look forward to having dinner with you guys tomorrow night.
Finish out.
So like I said, two apiece. It's been mainly Bud. The score is flattening Vinny in a way at the moment.
Well, 2-2, it definitely is.
But yeah, well, I still think it should have been 3-1.
Yeah.
But that's how this game goes. 1-0 error.
4-0, really. Could be 4-0.
He did butcher a couple balls in that frame.
Vinny or Bud?
Bud. That five up the top.
That's what I mean. It could be 4-0. Yeah.
Could have been. We don't play this game on what could have been.
That's true.
Just what is.
We'd all be through to the next day. Well.
You see, he's not famous for his break, but what kind of break is that for a 10 ball? Hey, it's ridiculous.
George,
and a shot
George
on the
ridiculous.
One. George Ridiculous? What? Oh, dude, you know I like the guy.
Me too.
Some people at home smiling right now for that comment. So this guy breaks, makes a couple balls. Gets on the one. This game's too easy. I tell you what, it wasn't the best position shot I've ever played. Unless that goes in the corner. Well, the good thing is for him, the five is in the hole. Oh, he's doing an elevated cue. Very difficult queuing
in the
elevated. Very difficult queuing. Makes it look easy. I hate him. Beautiful to watch, Sean. Beautiful to watch.
Okay, bit of work to do here.
Did he really play the kiss on the black?
No,
just
I don't
now?
Think so. Two cushions, has to be.
No, he must have. Because at the speed he played it, he must be playing the kiss on the black. That's a great shot. It's a great shot. He's got a bit of work here, he's on the wrong. He's done a good place now to get to the seven. Force follow with top left. He's thinking about it. I think he's going to force follow this ball. No, he's screwing back. What's he doing? He's playing the double.
You reckon?
Or the safe.
Not sure what's happening there.
I don't know. I didn't see him nominate.
Me either.
Tell you what though, Vinny played a character building match in this semi-final against Jason Ahmed. Jason Ahmed today, a big hello from me, the Mule. You
great
played
there,
fantastic all day today.
Great safety there.
Vinny was down, all of a sudden, bingo.
All of a sudden, three
Geronimo. He just woke up and got it first and ran every single rack. I like these kick shots. You get these kick shots well. Just like he's played it, and you can get a snooker back out of it. Fantastic. And again, this is what I'm talking about. Can you outfox the fox?
This is not easy.
Can you outfox the shot, the
hit
bud
the
man?
Seven, flick the six to the side rail, maybe, but he's thinking about
holding the white ball with the seven?
I think so. What? Any other?
That's what he's thinking about doing? Putting the six up the top, hooking you behind the nine and ten. Can he execute? Oh, it's a good shot. It's a great shot. Delicious. I like that. Great shot from Vinny Calabrese. And the question and the answer to that question is yes, he can outfox the
boys. Yeah.
Great shot. I didn't know that. I didn't know Bud actually owned the jump cue.
He's actually all right with it too.
Yeah?
Yeah, he got it. The cue action like that, he's going to be hitting it straight, that's for sure.
Oh, he almost made it. Oh, he hooked him back. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Well, we're going to find out if any can use one.
Wow. Wow. Vinny prefers to kick at balls. He doesn't like jumping that often.
Was.
That's a good kick shot.
Wow.
That's a really good kick shot.
Where did that kiss go?
What happened with the kiss?
Vinny, you're in front of the camera.
Aye.
Still not easy. He's got to play cannon on the eight.
I think that's a very good call there.
Oh, no, he's going around the back.
What a shot. What a shot. Wow. The Bud Man. Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching a living legend of Australian Q Sports right now. In his element. You know what I like him to? I like him to like a tiger stalking in the jungle when he's playing pool.
Yeah. You pop your head out with a mistake and you're going to get eaten.
Eating people alive, the Bud Master. So famous that they had to drink after, did you know
and
that?
He actually was lucky to get out of his last 32 today. He's down 6-2, 6-3, first match.
I mentioned that 10 minutes ago. Yeah. He was down 7-3 and he bingo.
Awoke the tiger.
Three, two. And this is the race to 11, so it's a long race. Players get to stretch out their arms a little bit. Vinny's been using a Mez Q recently. Doing very well with it.
Yeah, it's mine.
What do you mean it's yours? It's your Q?
The back part is.
The back part?
Yeah, he rang me up. He doesn't know. He goes, have you got a butt for a Q? Well, I said, well, I've got one that's Danny's, but you can use it if you want.
That's because
Chris. Hey, lucky you reminded me. I think I told him he owes me a couple hundred for it. He was using it. If he wins a title, surely he owes me more than that.
Hit him up. If he wins a tournament, hit him up for the cash.
20% commission.
Oh, you cracked me up, Gavin. Three to the bud. This is where he's really dangerous. This is his safety play.
Oh.
Look at this shot. Oh, hang on. Oh, this stick its head out a little bit, but still, I can't see him getting from the one to the two unless he pulls off a massive shot. Again, elevated cue. Whenever you elevate a cue, ladies and gentlemen, it's very hard. Very hard to execute a shot. Again, Mr. Bud, just taking what the table gives him. He had no way to get back to the twos. He just said, you know what, I'm going to back myself to pot this shot. Give myself another shot and back myself to pot this one as well. And why not when you can pot like that? What a gem of a shot that was. Wow. Well, I don't, even though they kind of look like they're all blotched up, they're actually, once one ball's potted, the other ball opens up. He's
6-7, maybe.
All he needs is just to have, I think this is the key shot right here, getting on the four correctly. And you see again, I mean, I'm thinking how's he going to get up to the top of the four. Just keeping this, just keeps the game simple. That's why he's there, you and me aren't here, and a bunch of other reasons.
We aren't here, or we aren't
no,
here?
We are here. We are here. Takes what the table gives him.
Yep.
Honestly,
now,
dude, so
this
far.
This has to be a cannon here, or is he going to play one rail in ball on the seven?
Sorry?
Is he going to play a cannon? Good to flick the seven away
he's
from the six.
He's got too much chance. He's just done up and down, man. No, he's just done down the bottom rail and come back out of it, isn't he? He doesn't want to play cannons here. Surely. Just done it down, bounce up. There you go. Wow, he put a lot of outside English there. What's going on? He did not want to be there at all. I mean, it's still okay. He could run forward, top right-hand spin, come up one, two, three rails. But yeah, he likes to go far. He'll go bottom. Efren's Z shot. One, two, and back out again, but no.
Well, what's happening here?
You didn't put enough side on the ball. Didn't put enough side on the ball. He's indicated the double. He's nailed doubles all day long, this guy. Can't see him missing this, no. All day long, man. All day long, it doubles balls. Nice follow through shot coming here. Following through. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen.
That's the third time the Baz has stitched him up.
What is the foundation of a good house?
Marvin's a brick all of a sudden. Concrete's the foundation of a good house, your peanut.
But when you want to erect it, you use bricks.
Well, when you want to erect it, you use a carpenter.
A brick shot. That was a brick.
Honestly, it's going to be 3-all. We've barely seen Vinny play.
No, well,
it's going to be 3-all. We've barely seen Vinny play.
Tree. Okay.
He's just mopping up. He's mopping up from Bud's mistakes.
But he's hanging in there.
Oh. That's how the way this game goes. Bud's getting in first. He finishes or he messes up. And then three apiece.
I wanted to say thanks to all our families, Baz, for letting us come down here for the weekend. A big turnout from New South Wales.
20-something?
22 people from New South Wales, guys. 22 people. 22 players.
We have massive turnout.
I think we have 88 runners tomorrow, is that right? For the nine ball?
Well, I know it's a lot of runners. 80 or 90 for sure. I'll be home and say thanks for letting me come down here. Thanks for letting me go to Vegas next year and the year after. And the year after. I appreciate it, babe.
You're a very lucky man, Gav.
That's
very
true,
lucky
that's
man.
True, Baz.
Okay, here we go. Vinny with a ball in hand. Has got a chance to put himself one frame in front. And yes, I fully back Vinny to run this rack out in 1 minute, 20 seconds.
Okay, let's get the clock.
Get the clock out. One.
Get your what?
Okay, you know what? Let's be fair. 1 minute, 27 seconds. Go.
I still haven't found the clock on the iPhone, so...
Find the start clock, man. Nah. Find the stopwatch. Nah. I'm sure at home you could time this. Ooh. No, he's missed it. He's chopped that one. It just... I don't know. It just didn't look like Vinny there. It looked like he quickly stroked it, got down and shot it. But that's the way he always looks. He always quickly strokes the ball. Bud's loving this. He's loving this.
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bud just screwed the ball straight back and put it on a dime. The seven ball is in a precarious position.
That's a good word,
man. He's really got to land. Thank you.
It's Tom of the Night.
I'm a living thesaurus.
Thesaurus.
Thesaurus. He's got to land really close to the rail. Or maybe...
Maybe not.
Maybe not, because I really thought the seven ball was close to the knuckle. It's obviously he's got space there. Yeah, he's fine. And he's on the right side of the black ball, I believe. Oh, he just done it.
Oh, he needs a result. Doesn't want that to fall in.
He's fine. I love how Bud just shook his head really quickly, but still got down the shot automatically. 4-3 is very fair. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have a quick little timeout here from Sean. Back in a couple minutes. Don't go anywhere. We're back, ladies and gentlemen, really quickly. It's Bud can't ask for a break because it's not his break. Again, Vinny's been breaking the best all day long. Come on, Vinny. Come on, buddy. One good shot here from Vinny sets up the whole frame. That's it. Sends a message to your opponent, hey man, I'm here to play. I know you're Mr. Sean Bud, I'm not intimidated by you. Do you know who I am? I'm Vinny Calabrese. We all know who you are, Vinny. Legend on and off the table. That's where it counts most. Like I said, Gavin.
Well, not straight.
1 minute, 27 seconds, that's all he needs. Come on.
Come on, Baz.
Come
that
on,
is five man. Times, Baz.
No, that's not me. That's not me. Don't make
come
it sound
on, Barry,
like it's me.
That's five times.
That's just lazy. Honestly, Vinny, you are...
I don't believe in coincidence. It's
you
not
are the
five
best,
times.
Man. Get your head
yeah,
down.
That's five. You're five for five. Okay, two
down,
cushions
Vinny.
Or screw back?
Come on, buddy.
Screw back. A little bit of screw back.
That's not a shot Vinny should miss.
No, of course not.
It makes me sick to see that. Seriously. Vinny needed to respond there and respond in that frame. Going 5-3 down now to Mr. Bud, that's not a good position to be in. And when you're missing straight balls like that, you're sending a message, hey, maybe I'm not really here to play. That was a question mark I had in my mind before. Vinny's a lot better than that. Okay, now we're going to go for a break because it's Mr. Bud's break. We're back in a couple of minutes, ladies and gentlemen. No, we're not.
Hey, now you're on. What's the language? Now you're on.
I want to say a big special shout out and a big hello and a thank you to a very, very close friend of mine listening from Cairns at the moment. Mr. Float, you know who you are, Dane Float. I miss you, my man. Come down to Sydney and we'll drink a few beers and shoot some ball together next time you're around. Tell you what though, from yesterday to today the tables are breaking a lot easier. They're making balls at the break. There's an open shot in the one again.
I think that's the control of the two players that have left.
Well, that could be why the two players left. They're breaking very well. We didn't see a lot of break and runs yesterday.
10 ball, it's
mind you, it was like a 16-hour day in here yesterday. We started playing 9 o'clock in the morning, we finished 3 o'clock in the morning.
It was the biggest day I've ever
the balls got ball. Dirty, it was humid and raining outside, the tables got moist, it was just a messy day.
People were getting a little bit dizzy.
Mate, when you finish playing pool at 3 o'clock in the morning and you have to come back at 9 o'clock and play an Australian Ocean title like this, it's not easy. And Sean's not young, he must be in his mid-40s right now. Yeah, it's not easy. I felt sorry for Robbie Fulvari. Who's in his mid-50s.
Usually he gets blamed for holding up the whole tournament. It wasn't him this time.
Actually, Robbie Fulvari, you know, I feel like whenever he joins the tournament, he's favourite. For me, he's the hardest player to beat in the country. He's so difficult to beat. He's a great player. And he was actually playing quite quick. He was playing quite quick today. Maybe that's
not
why
compared
he didn't...
to Vinny.
But no. Compared to himself. Yeah, so, you know, he was playing quite quick.
And he didn't finish last night till 3:30, actually.
That's what I was saying.
So he had to lob up this morning at 9 o'clock.
I kind of felt sorry for him, and I kind of felt like he was disadvantaged because he's an older gentleman. He needs his sleep. He can't finish 3:30
well,
in the morning and then
sleep.
Come back here at 9 o'clock.
I need my sleep too.
You're young, man. It's as you get older, it gets harder. All right, back to the game here. You know, Bud's doing what he does. And at the moment, from what I've seen, Gavin, I like Bud to win this match. If I had to put my money down right now, I'd say Bud's winning this match.
That's six on, past the nine, must be. And I'll tell you, if he runs, he's took four balls out and
I need to see something more from Vinny to convince me. Mr. Budman is just doing his work.
Well.
Queuing so good. The only medium hard shot is this one here, but this is easy for Bud. Stun right, one rail out. The young lady you can see there sitting next to Vinny is Vinny's girlfriend, Joey. You know what? I'm putting a curse on everybody today. How did Bud miss that shot? Thank you.
Oh no. Yuck.
I'm very surprised Sean missed that black ball before. Honestly, he wasn't missing anything in the last match. Against Phil Riley, he didn't miss anything. He was just a machine.
They are perhaps, playing for perhaps a big title.
Perhaps the Budman still feels it after so many years of winning titles, still feels a bit of pressure.
Oh,
perhaps. I just don't think this guy's human. By the way, I was just informed by the boys here that she's actually not his girlfriend. She's just a friend of his. My mistake, guys.
Ooh. Slow down or speed up?
No, he wants it to speed up, and I think he's got there. Living dangerously as a bud man at the moment. Top left-hand spin. Gee, Bud is looking good, isn't he? He's looking solid,
man. Well, there's
been
a few smaller frames, and hopefully puts this one away.
Okay, there's been three or four bad shots, but it's expected. You are playing in a very big tournament.
There's a lot of people here.
It's late. He's been playing for 2 days straight. He was here till 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning last night as well.
And yeah, 4 hours waiting before his first match.
Yeah, it's a big factor. Two rows, a bit left. Coming from the Budmaster. 1-2. What a beautiful shot. You know what? This shot gave me trouble today. On the fast table. It's just so easy to overrun.
Screw back?
He's screwing back. He's on the rail. He's left a little tester, but this is not, honestly, this is not a shot that's going to worry, Bud. Well done, Bud.
Can I say I wish I could play like Sean Bud?
You're not the only one. You can say it for all of us. Oh, here we go. Someone get Jenny a drink.
Oh, the music is pounding and blasting here at the Empire at the moment, guys.
Jenny's up on the podium.
We've got Jenny dancing around. Everyone's having a good time. Everyone, honestly, there's a good crowd of 40, 50 people watching this match at the moment, which is a really good crowd. And of course, all the viewers at home. On Cueball TV, the best Q sports site in Australia, ever.
In the world.
Period.
In the world.
Ever, period. The best.
And the ones you watch, try and watch overseas, they always want you to pay $12 to watch two ham sandwiches.
Yeah, they got usually got some, guy with a funny accent talking as well.
Yeah. Not.
Honestly, how boring is commentary sometimes? I watch it so I can go to sleep.
Sometimes you just got to watch
maybe somebody might think our commentary is boring, but.
I'd say so.
All right, Bud's going to have to push out here because he can barely see the ball. Wow. Unless he feels he can do something like thin clip it and snooker him somehow. Honestly, this final so far has been about 90% Bud. About 90% Bud.
Well, I think he's got 90% of the balls.
And
not much doing there. Maybe
that's not a good safety shot. I think he couldn't see a lot of the ball. Maybe he might have been better for him to push. I'm not going to second guess Bud here. Reckon Vinny will take this on.
Combo.
He's very aggressive. He took on a combination in the semi-final, which was very difficult. Much harder than this one. Just missed it. No, he's not going to take this on. He knows this is a different time here.
No, he's flicking it behind the eight.
He knows it's a different game. He had the advantage.
That's a good shot.
That's a great shot. That's what I want to see. He's got to stay close to Bud. This is a race to 11. Bud's already over halfway home. Here's Mr. Bud with a jump cue again. And this guy's good with any cue in his hand. But this time, it's not going to pay any dividends.
So the new rules too, Barry, of 10 ball. No early 10s this tournament. It's slowed things down a lot.
Yes, it has. 10 ball's become a much better game now they got rid of that.
Oh,
that,
definitely.
Get rid of the early combinations. He's going to get high on this 2-ball shot. Oh.
A little bit of side there, I don't think he wanted.
He's overcooked that by a good couple of feet. Vinny, when he plays, he likes to move his white ball around. Really does. At the corner. He's going to control both the white, the 3. Make sure he gives himself a shot. That's where he played at rail first.
Good shot.
And that is a good shot. If you're left-handed.
What do you want?
Being a snooker player is very adept to using the rest. And look at Vinny, swinging around. Not wasting any time, he's playing pool like his hair's on fire. Nice and quick, 1-2.
How's going,
very well, how are you going, James? Good, good, good. I'm not going to say anything from this point on, Gavin, because of what's happened the last 5 or 6 racks.
Yeah, good idea. He's been commentating.
Every time I said these guys are out, they miss it. They chop up a ball.
Oh, he's not missing that one. I'm prepared to go out on a limb here.
Beautiful to watch, Vinny. Absolutely beautiful to watch, my man. Make it look too easy. Well done.
Okay, 6-5.
You know what? I like the rack your own rule. I like the rack your own rule.
Well, in normal,
I don't like racking for your opponent because whenever my opponent racks for me, if I have a bad break, I think they just hot rack me. But okay. I have to say there have been a couple of deviant characters in Australia that pattern rack.
You're allowed to pattern rack.
You're allowed to pattern rack.
You're allowed to pattern rack?
No, you're not allowed to pattern rack.
No, you are.
Me, you are.
We had a query last year.
And they said it's a cat of pattern rack.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to go and ask that person for some lessons then.
Yeah. Last year the guy running the tournament, I forget his name, he plays two-shot with the glass, I forget his name. He was playing Greg and he was saying you rack him the same every time, so they went and checked the rules and it's actually all right.
It's all right to pattern rack. Oh, that's the first I've heard about it.
That was 9-ball, might be different.
Anybody pattern racks, I mean, that's...
If you know that much, good on you anyway.
That's a bad shot. Yuck. Again, this is where Vinny had to really make another statement.
Yeah, just...
He really has to put the pressure on, Bud. But he's really hooked himself a doozy here. There's a chance he can make this.
That's close. That is close.
That looks good.
What a shot.
Oh, God.
What a shot. Wow.
That is ridiculous.
Wow.
That is awesome.
Second best shot of the tournament after being safety in the final.
That is awesome. Thanks for the drinks, guys. If you're Budman sitting in the corner in his chair right now, he's feeling sick. Yeah, he's feeling sick.
That is a posture changer.
Trust me though, not much is going to faze Sean. He's seen everything. He's been around that long. He's seen everything. But yes, Vinny, you are the man.
a little bit straight.
He hasn't got a lot of angle on this. Played it rail first, ladies and gentlemen. That is a great shot. Rail first, plumb on the 10. Beautiful, Vinny. Beautiful.
Didn't even want to move the magic rack.
Didn't want to move it, though. No. Forget about it.
Leave it there for Sean. Save him a trip to the couch.
Six on the house, ladies and gentlemen.
That's Chris Calabrese here.
Handsome Chris Calabrese here. Six. Someone's left their wallet there.
How are you feeling?
I just found the wallet. I'm feeling really
not again.
Second time this week, I fell off. Is that yours?
No, it's not mine. It's going to be Mitch's probably, because you're sitting there. So, Chris, you've been watching the match, obviously.
I've been watching a little bit. Tucker just leaves his shit hanging around, doesn't he?
Yeah, just leave it here. I'll give it to him.
There's no money in it anyway, don't worry about it.
Wait till we go back to the view, to the other view, and look at the top left. This view here that Dan is on, top left.
Oh, can you see? I can hear everything you're saying.
But top left, you can't see the writing on it. Can you see the writing on it?
No, you can't.
Writing on what?
On the paper that's standing up there.
Six apiece at the moment. Fair result. Yes.
Well,
I still think Buck could be up 7-5.
Vinny would be happy with 6-all, I reckon, at this stage.
I think so too.
Yeah, very good quality match. It's great to see just basically an attacking final. Sometimes you have a player that plays a lot of safety, but these guys, they're both back in their ability with the long potting and they're just going nuts.
What a break.
It's really good to see. We always knew that these two players are, you know, probably the two most solid players here, and it's good to see the two pretty much consistent players going through. Vinny and Sean, both with snooker background, and they both adapt to pool style quite easily. It comes second nature to them. Sean's played pool so much, and I'm just putting this headgear on now. So
everybody knows who you are.
Everyone knows me as Vinny's brother, so
oh, he's listed up.
I'm here.
Vinny's brother.
Yeah. I think I'm struggling to put it on. I've had a couple of drinks. But yeah, it's all good, man. It's good to see Vinny here. I convinced him to play. He didn't want to play. And I said, come on, bro, let's go and play some pool. And he said, yeah, why not?
Said so, easy, $2,000 for you, are you, Vinny? Come down and burgle all these other guys.
Yeah.
We all know how proud of your brother you are. We all know how proud you are.
Yeah, absolutely. So.
But you're also his biggest critic as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I still think, as well as he is going, he's still playing a lot of the wrong shots. But, hey, he's in the final, so what can you say?
And you were the man that won this tournament last year.
I semi-finals in the 10 ball and I won the 9 ball, which is on tomorrow. So, yeah, so, no, it's good. Hopefully I can do some damage tomorrow, but if I can't, that's just the way
you
it goes.
You doing tonight?
I'm doing some damage at the moment, apparently. But like I tell a lot of people, in this game, which is one of the games that I love, you lose a lot more than you win. Doesn't matter how good you are.
What do you mean by that?
So basically, when you play the game, you lose a lot more than you win.
So, can you elaborate?
Yeah, I can actually. So, say you play 20 matches.
You lose 11.
You must probably lose 11 and you'd win 9.
That makes sense.
So that makes sense to everyone out there? No. What I'm saying is, you know, I have been one of the most consistent players going around, most probably over the last 12 months. And I'm happy with my achievements, but doesn't matter how consistent you are, you can still lose, and it's, you know, proof that everyone's got a chance in these tables, which is great. The conditions are great, the pockets are quite generous, so it's just the way it is. There's so many great players here, and you know, even if you play flawless, you can still lose, because it's just the way it is. It's not like snooker. If someone's clearly better, they're going to win 95% of the time.
That's a good shot.
You know, 30% better on this, and they can still get rolled in one game, in one match. So yeah, but Sean just played an excellent shot under the cushion there.
That ball, like the three that are buried in the pocket, actually quite hard to play when it's inside the pocket.
Yeah, absolutely.
This is a test shot right now.
Yeah, he's just got to just float this in. And he's hit a plum. He's got the 10 as well. Hopefully he doesn't get snookered. There you go, plum. He just dropped this in with a hair of right. Just to float the white past the around the center, around the pink spot, or actually he's hit it quite firm, so even better. Perfect. So it's always been what it's been. I haven't been watching the whole match, but I think it's always been within one or two frames.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's awesome to see. Has there been many break and runs, guys?
Not really break and runs. The pebbles aren't breaking that well.
Yeah.
The whole tournament hasn't been any break and runs anyway.
Yeah, it has been. It has been a bit like that.
There'll be a lot more break and runs in the volleyball. No more systems.
Yeah. But in saying that, the nine's going to be on the spot, so...
Three ball pass the headstring.
No, and three balls have to pass the headstring, or three-point rule, which means you have to pot a ball, which is worth 1 point, or balls go past the headstring, which calculates to 1 point per ball that going past. But in the past, we've always had the one ball on the spot, which means the wing ball goes straight in. That's not the case anymore. So it's a lot harder to make sure you get a ball in and get the three-point rule. So really good match. Vinny and Sean have had some good matches over the years, and I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure it's pretty even.
The final they played at Mount is the best match I've ever seen, the snooker in the Australian Open. Best match I've ever seen.
Yeah, so snooker, it went 6-5 to Sean. Vinny had an awesome, I think, 59 clearance in the 10th frame to go 5-all, and then it was a black ball game in the last?
Black ball game, Vinny made 60.
Yeah, Vinny made 50-odd 60, and Sean, awesome, with a 40-odd break, and then potted about 6 or 7 balls into the centre at pace from underneath the black, and did really well. Yeah, but while we're here, I'd just like to say big showing from our interstate players, especially New South Wales, with 20-odd players turning up, which is great to see. The love for the game in New South Wales is definitely there. We had three or four players from Melbourne, a couple from Perth, so it's great to see. And Adelaide putting up a good showing with about 50-odd runners. So, yeah, New South Wales has been developing really nice with the new association that's come on board, and the people are really passionate. Not saying that the old people weren't, but it's just seemed to move in a really nice direction over the last 6 to 12 months. And I've been happy with it. I've won a lot of tournaments, so yeah, it's been good. I thought I'd just get that in.
Yeah, we're also very lucky we've got Walter from City Heroes who puts up his tables for us.
Walter is an absolute champion. That's, like you said, from City Heroes. He's the owner and operator of City Heroes on George Street in Sydney. So if you're ever in that area on George Street in Sydney, just Google it. You can't miss it. It's right underneath the cinemas. Event Cinemas in George Street. He's an absolute genius. But talking about venues, we're at the Empire at the moment. It is a fantastic place. Always love coming here. Alex and the crew, Alex Evanaris.
Oh, no.
He just supports all the players, always helping out. And the golden phrase is, Color Breezy, Chris, is a genius. If you say that, you get a free drink. So
if you say that, you get asked to leave. He knows you've had too much to drink.
You get a free drink. So when you come here, just say, Chris Color Breezy, you are a legend. Doesn't matter who serves you, they know. It's straight away, free drink. That's just the rule. I don't know. It's a rule they've had in place for over 10 years. So.
10 years? I don't think so.
You are a legend.
Nah. But yeah, no.
Okay. Not easy here, Baz.
Sorry?
Not easy here, Baz. Yeah. Get on the 3-5 that play the combo.
I think, I don't know how straight he is. He might be able to, it looks like he can't follow through and go in between the 7 and 6, so he might be stunning across, yeah? And playing the combo. Yeah, absolutely.
It's not an ABC app, but it does depend on how he makes a combination and lands on the 3 to get on the 4. This is definitely the key shot this frame.
That's you have to be careful with that pocket. You walk around, you could fall in. yeah. Anyway, I'm going to put Mr. Barry Mavros on. Thank you guys for letting me have a couple minutes of my 15 minutes of fame here. So,
thank you very much, Chris.
Thanks, Chris.
But whoever wins tonight, they deserve it. They're both playing well. Thank you.
That was a wonderful insight.
I haven't been drinking for a couple of months, and I'm having a couple tonight.
That was
that's a good shot there.
Wonderful to have Chris Calabrese come and join us in the commentary box. Always an honour to talk to Chris. A gentleman of the sport and one of the best players I've ever seen in my life. And I do mean that.
Nice stunt run through there.
Scores are still 7-6, right? Score 7-6.
7-6?
Yep.
7-8, 8-9. A little bit of slight screw back. One cushion stunt here, Bass.
I'll tell you what, though. Sean is looking very solid.
No, he always looks solid.
He really is.
That's why people
solid.
Fall apart.
He played just like this in the 10 ball when he won the state 10 ball here.
It's a little bit short.
About a month and a half ago. Yes.
No, that's all right.
Sorry, guys. Chris Calabrese back again. Just wanted to say a big shout out to the Queensland players. There's about 10 of them. And
well, that's true, too.
It's really awesome to see them come and support Daniel Shepherd out there and Alvin and Bean.
Alvin made the quarters.
Alvin made the quarters. Yeah, Alvin made the quarters.
Bean made the final.
Big raps on Alvin. I've seen him play over the last 6 months and highly respect him. I respect everyone, but as a player, I think he's so talented. So keep going at it, Alvin. I think there's bigger and better things for you. If you have the time to play, I know you're working so much. Bean, unlucky today, but Marudi, well done. Bean, I know how good you are. And Marudi, you're very good too. You're all both great. You're both world class. So well done to you, Marudi. And Bean,
I think you can
get one back for yourself on Marudi in the 9 ball, because I'm very confident I'm not sure he beat you two in the final again. And the New Zealanders, Matt Edwards, Marudi, everyone, David Breen, you always come here and support, or when we go to your place, you look after us. So thank you very much to that.
A couple of Western Australians too.
Western Australia.
Ben Judge just walked
in the house and he's like, hey, how you guys going?
Did he go to the bar or no? Did he go straight to the bar?
He's good, man. Ben Judge, he doesn't care what it is. If there's a tournament on,
and
there's
a bar there, he'll be
there. It could be a $5 tournament in
Timbuktu.
Adelaide.
Hey, Ben Judge, I haven't seen him in 6 years.
He's not a man of words. Many words.
Don't go searching for a conversation.
He will be when he sees me. Last time I saw him, we were that blind we could barely walk.
Well, yeah, I believe that.
And we said goodbye to each other. I told him I was leaving to go overseas. I haven't seen him for a long time. Where is he?
He's at the bar.
Bring him over.
I'll bring him over. All right, I'll get it.
Actually, maybe after the match is over.
Yeah.
And of course, Cue Ball TV. Mr. Lynch right here.
Legend.
Are you playing in the 9 ball tomorrow, Mr. Lynch? He sure is.
Bloody oath, he says. Bloody oath.
And his games are the only ones that are going to be streamed.
Just going to talk. Jenny's okay, taking thanks. It.
All right, while we have this intermission, we're going to have a little brief intermission with Jenny. Jenny, how are you going, my dear? Should I say Jenny Budd? Yeah. Is that how I should introduce you? Jenny Budd, and this is Budd's partner, and we're aware of that. How do you think the match is going? You've been watching the match? Of course you've been watching the match.
Of course I've watched the match.
Yes.
Oh, look, they're both fantastic players. Mm-hmm. They're awesome. Photo.
Jeez. Back to the commentary. Everyone's at home listen to us talk. They are.
They're favourites in my mind.
I think they're the best two players of the tournament today.
Exactly.
Absolutely. They played better than anybody else today.
So.
Well, we know who you're backing.
Of course, I've got to back Sean. I love Vincent.
Yeah, Vinny's great too.
Known him for a long time. He's part of my family.
Well, we're back from our intermission. Thanks for spending some time with us, Jenny. I'll be seeing you at the bar as soon as the commentary is over. We're back, guys. Score is now 8-6, Budd in front. Budd has been in front the majority of this match. And it's time for that. That's that time of the evening when there's a dry break. Nothing down.
A dry break and not a lot of options. The in-off's got to be close.
Well, it's not exactly. That's got to be table. In-off the all day. The six ball is not open, so
I don't think it'll be potting that one, Badge.
Oh,
normally he pops in the right hand corner or left hand corner on the table.
You know, he's one of the best safety players I've seen in the country. I've got to say this. If I don't say this, I won't feel good about myself. Reljic, David Reljic, one of the best safety players I've seen in the country.
Oh, he's one of the best all-round players on this table.
You know I always rate Dave.
He's a pest with the videos on Facebook, but I'll tell you.
He's going for this, man. He's going for this. Oh. See, discretion, I think.
The part, better part of valor.
Hindsight's a wonderful thing, but discretion may be better there. Playing a good safety shot. Just waiting for a better opportunity to shoot.
I'm sure Ogle's be sneaking up behind me and giggling. Something's happening.
Budman's got a shot at this ball now and a chance to open up the 6 and the 7.
What a Duncan. Okay.
If he chose to.
It's quite... Well, it's got to be the double or safety. Too thin, you reckon, Barry, to get up there? Look, kilometres on the left-hand side, it's ugly.
Yeah, he's going to double. It's too thin. Does that six ball pass? I can't see. It must pass. If he's not trying to move it, it must pass. Yeah, I'm not expecting Budman to miss a double.
Oh!
He's
jump cue again.
Ball. Oh. This could be the opportunity that Vinny needs to claw back up again because he's fallen 2 frames behind here. And we're getting close to the finishing line. Honestly, I've been watching.
That looks too close to me. I'm not genius with the jump cue, but that looks a little bit close. Unless it's jumping over half a ball. If he's jumping over half a ball, he might be okay, but that's a full ball. That looks very close.
The dart motion, you know, when you... Yeah, this way. This is the only way you can jump over the ball that close. Darting it. Just gotta be careful he doesn't jump the white ball off the table here. Very careful. Just pop it.
What a shot from
the bud. Anything made out of wood, don't put in this guy's hands. He's a freaking magician.
Is he on it? Must be.
Anything made out of wood, don't give it to him. Give him a toothpick, he'll fucking run out with it. Crazy guy. What a great shot that was from the Budmeister. The Budmeister. All right, so just pull off a great shot. But he needs another good shot here. Float this in the... This is what I was saying before about the fox.
Vinny should hit this. 2 cushions,
Vinny might make this because he's good at these shots.
Not far off.
That's good. That's a good result.
If he gets behind it,
it's a bloody great result for Vinny. It's a great result. Now, does Bud have to play the similar shot now? Or can he see the edge of the top part of the four? Where he's looking, it looks like he can see the top part of the four. To do with some kind of resafe, maybe.
Flick 2 cushions up behind the 8.
I'm not sure, man.
No, I think he's sending the 4 up near the 7.
Is going to do Budman the genius.
4 up near the 7.
Staying the ball. You can see a lot more of this ball than we can think. You can see this. You can see the whole ball.
Yeah, beautiful.
You can see the whole ball. Wonder if Vinny will play a similar shot
I think Vinny's taking it on the way he's got down there.
Push the pink 2 rails and use it. No, on the other way.
Good shot.
This is a key frame, you know.
Big frame.
It's a huge frame. If Vinny doesn't win this frame, he falls 3 frames behind.
Big frame.
If he wins this frame, he's 1 frame in it. I mean, it's a huge frame.
Sean's going to play the same shot, 4 into the 6.
4 into the 6, coming around 2 rails, trying to get him on the 9. Don't want to flick a ball there, no. That's a good shot from Mr. Bud. That's a really good shot. I've got a lovely young man here who wants to join us in the commentary box for a couple of minutes while I have a little break. His name is Mitchell Takara. We're going to say a big special shout out to Mr. Paul Bailey, who's at home watching. Hello, Mr. Paul. We miss you, my man. We wish you were here. If you were here, there'd be some beers on the bar right now.
Go the Raiders, Paul. And by the way, look after me in the handicap department.
Hi, folks.
Okay, Mitch, jump cue coming out. Needs to get this safe because the balls are pretty open. Oh, that's going to be okay. The nine's going to cover that pocket.
Got to be happy with that. He hasn't had much luck this match, so you take that.
Joined by the handsome Jamie Walker, snuck up behind me like a Kiwi after a sheep. Say hello.
G'day, how's it going?
Good, mate. You have a good weekend so far?
Yep. It's been a very exciting last couple of days in Adelaide. The weather's just turned right, but it doesn't matter. We've been inside all bloody
3 days straight.
Been here till 3 a.m. in the morning.
Here's a chance.
Big day yesterday, wasn't it?
It's a big finish, especially playing Robbie Baldivari last. So I think we finished a record timing.
Did you put this song on?
No.
Okay.
I am wearing blue.
You are wearing blue, that's true.
I am blue. How are we going here, boys? Well, the Budstone.
Key frame here, Vinny needs to win this frame.
Perfect.
Two cushions. Beautiful.
It's just in the right mode at the moment. Don't think, just do.
Good for Vinny's arm, must be frozen at the moment.
Okay, 8-7.
Special shout out to these Boneheads, part of the Mascotti Cup clan.
City Mafia?
Yeah, City Mafia. James El Presidente, Hardy.
Des for Press.
Yeah, Des
for Press.
Craig Riley.
Gmail. Craig Gmail Riley.
Yeah. That'd be a good commentary team one day. Daniel Magoo. I'm sure he's watching this.
Got sort of. Yeah.
It's going to have an exciting final.
Oh, it's good to have these two in the final.
Yeah, they make
attacking cool. People like Riley and that, it's good to watch.
They really do make Paul look exciting.
Good one, Sean.
Nice one, bud.
Well done, mate.
Good process for White. He's breaking out.
Vinny's just hanging on like a koala, isn't he? He could have been shut out of this match.
He's right, he should have been shut out probably, yeah. He's right into it, that's for sure.
Himself.
Yeah, he's looking confident too, actually.
So, how many runners have we had this weekend?
We had 60 something for yesterday, and I think we got 80 or 90 for tomorrow. So, yeah. So pack your sleeping bag for group sessions.
Yeah, well, I believe I'm on the afternoon session.
So that means night time, morning session.
3 o'clock.
3 a.m. Yeah. Session.
Yeah, well, last night I matched off on the table at 6:30.
Strong.
Finished the last game at 2:45 a.m.
Okay.
Session plays all right.
It's horrible, I think. Groups are horrible.
But you learn how to play on these tables. These tables are different.
I'm going to upgrade to Jamie Walker.
Not much trouble here for Vinny, really. Should run this out. 8 and 9 in good positions. Oh, I'll get off the rail. Okay. Nice loose grip.
Yeah. Very good at punching a ball, Vinny is.
Little bit up and down the table, and then stop shot. Oh, wants it to slow down. Perfect.
Oh, spit straight.
Oh, there you go.
Should
just
be
punch
able to put a little bit.
No, off one cushion.
Easy peasy.
Okay,
Jeff, eight
all. That was a quick frame. Vinny might be heating up, and if he heats up, the frames could be very quick.
Yeah, Vinny's in Vinny mode. The breeze
mode. Once he starts to see him, they go in from all over the place.
Yep.
Eight all? Eight,
yep.
Seven.
Eight each. The two New South Welshmen are putting a show on tonight.
Oh, I don't know. Bud said a word about AFL.
AFL.
It's turned into a Mexican.
Aerial ping pong.
No, he might have moved here.
God, give me strength.
Oh, no. Someone needs to explain to me why that happens, because I see it all the time.
Well,
I
told
well.
You that Butter was going to go in off on this break.
He did too.
Yeah.
Butter's gone in off, and Vinny has got quite a not a bad looking table.
Vinny just ran 2 racks.
He ran that last rack quite quickly.
Yeah.
This is that spurt that I was talking about earlier. Yeah. That Vinny gets on these little mini rolls where he runs in and 3 or 4 racks a couple times.
He just doesn't think. He just don't. He just does it.
He's an instinct player.
Yeah.
He plays by instinct.
2 cushions we've left.
So beautiful to watch.
Very clean.
Just a little bit of a screw back. Okay, well this, I've got a feeling this is going to be a quick frame too. Eight,
so
nine.
You ran the last one
that's
out.
That's
fine.
Actually, I wasn't watching where they racked the 8 and 9 then, but both times the 8 and 9's been like that.
Treated to a feast of pool tonight. Absolute feast.
Oh, gee. He's feeling it now. Before he was put to play a stop shot and left it long, and now he's just pumping it in the side.
Yeah, it looks like he's taking up a gear.
Yeah.
He's actually moved the magic rack.
It was only
that's a first.
It was only a minute, minute and a half ago he moved it before.
He just pushed it to the side. We need that magic rack in a few seconds.
Oh, ladies and folks, so we have a new leader here.
Finally, Vinny is in front. First time in this match where it matters near the end.
2 to go.
That's right, you only want to be in front at one stage, and that's when it finishes.
It's pretty strong.
Jamie Walker, it's an honor to be doing commentary with you, my man. How are you going?
Yeah, I'm actually doing two.
Oh, no, Vinny's hit the front.
Pretty good at the moment.
For all of
just
you out there who don't know Jamie Walker that well, Jamie Walker's from New Zealand. And he was the master of the underarm play.
He's the master of the
underarm
fluke.
Underarm championship, he'd be the number one pick favorite to win every time.
Yeah, that's a good talent to have. I try to make Paul exciting, Barry.
I know you do. Someone has to.
Yeah, exactly. My time will come.
Okay. And is he? Oh, where's that white? Where's that white?
Oh, it's a bit harsh.
Is he on the one? I think he might be on it.
He might have to hit the rail.
But the 9 and 10 are stuck together. He's looking at them now.
Yeah, it doesn't.
He's eyeballing the 9 and 10.
It doesn't look pretty. Doesn't look pretty at all. But I'm thinking could just be a little bit. We could. Off the bottom rail, maybe clip it.
He has got a shot, but he's got to move that 9 and 10 somehow.
No, with the 8 there, he can land behind it. He can drop off the 8 behind that 9 and 10. He's just got to get rid of these balls. He doesn't want this kiss. But the 8's going in now.
Might like the belly head shot.
Nope, safety. Well, he won't be jumping that one.
That's what you call a thing in the head, folks.
No, it doesn't go. Well, it might go now, you reckon? Yeah, it might go now.
It's debatable.
Big kick shot here from Bugman.
Yeah.
He's got to hit this ball.
I've seen him done some freaky stuff today.
That's in.
And that could
That's going
in.
Straight in. Well.
Did he call it?
You know what? No, he didn't. He's going to be getting sent in. He's going to be getting sent in. That looks too far to jump. Too much of a stretch.
Well, you never know. If then he puts the Bud back in. Bud might fancy another jump shot here.
The Bud Factory might kick this ball and then make the black.
Yeah.
Bud's left-handed. Bud's left-handed, so he won't be able to reach that, I don't think, with a jump cue.
Good call there, Gavin.
Vinny can reach it.
Yeah. There's a high percentage that the white ball might go in the centre pocket as well.
Oh, you have to.
He should put it back in here. He can't shoot this.
He can't go that up and down behind the tent.
Yeah.
Oh, he knows.
This could be a big turning point in the game.
Surely he's not going to try and kick at it.
He's got to put it back in again, seriously.
Yeah. Be smart.
Pin a poker there. He turns around and says, you play.
Maybe, well, Bud's gone straight for the jump cue. Maybe he can reach it.
I love that. He turns around and goes, you play it. And then a big smile. But I tell you what, Bud's not smiling.
Half. Flick the 4, try and pot the 8.
He's in the zone, folks. Watch out.
He hasn't caught anything I didn't see.
He could be doing it Earl here. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Ball in hand here. Still got the 9-10 problem though in the corner. I think the 10 is just in the way. That could be a problem.
They
could do a free foul.
Surely it's on. He'll just stun across. Play. Oh, I've got a feeling he's in a mood now.
Lots of
he looks like he's ready to play.
Yeah, he's in the mood. He's awakened the giant within here.
Yeah, he's...
But it all depends. Does that 9-ball pass or not?
I don't think it's going to matter. He's going to get on it. And he might be able to nudge it now.
Kiss on him now.
Never know.
Big shot here. I think
he's gone too far.
I think he's stitched himself up.
That's okay. He's up and he'll get this safe.
This is where my underarm comes in handy in Mavros.
Yeah, except the 4 balls before you would have missed them.
Yeah, don't need to use a jigger.
Yeah.
That's very smart of him.
Snooker player safety, beautiful.
Bud loves to kick.
Tell you what, you want to hit this because this frame's going to last long if you don't.
Yeah.
You
know what I said earlier today, I said Vinny's the only man that I think can stop Sean today.
Yeah, well, Sean was very close in defeat this first round in the last 32.
You mentioned that earlier, the guy just, Sean just, hello.
Yeah.
Five in a row. Total clearances, no
three-ball clearances.
Total 50 balls in a row he potted.
Yeah. In the beginning, Bud was missing easy shots, though.
Under the pump when he needed to. That's a sign of it.
Yeah. Oh, he's called it, he's potted it. Oh man. That is so close. Only speed kept that out. Dead weight that drops.
Genius.
Still, that's still not. It hasn't left it real easy for Vinny.
The nine's still not open, so.
Is that definitely not on?
Nah, I think the 10's just in front of the 9.
I ran over to have a look, and it just looked like the 10's stopping the 9 from going in.
Yeah. Go on, Vinny. What are you going to do now, mate?
Oh, he's going to play his top right hand spin and knock him out.
No.
Nah, it can't be that adventurous.
Top right.
No, he's an aggressive player, but.
Have a go.
I don't think so. Not from there. That looks ugly. If that's on the back cushion, which it is, that's a big, big shot.
He's thinking about playing position to get the game ball in the middle pocket, guys.
But he could stitch himself up by snookering himself.
He's also on the back rail, which is very tough cueing.
Very limiting, limiting to
shot. And
the
centre pockets are very tight as well.
I lost two wallets in my foot in there before.
From this angle.
Okay, from where we're sitting.
He's right.
No one knows. Help us out.
I don't think even he knows at the moment. Still trying to work it out.
I don't think you can pump it in.
Top right and miss a bit of pocket.
Is it nine? We don't have the nines on. I don't think it is. What, throw the eight in?
Yeah.
Let's play it down the bottom. So oh, wow.
Oh.
You can hit it.
Just hit it a bit thick.
You know what? That might be on.
Yeah.
That might be on.
It might be on, but that's a ridiculously difficult shot.
That's a shot you've got to take.
Well, he's got to take it on. He has to take it on. What's he going to do? How's he going to play safe from there?
Got to get it in. Look like a hero.
You can definitely see enough of that to put it. How's he gone? How's he gone?
Short.
Oh, a little bit short. Unlucky. And in off too? No.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Hey, that's not easy. He can't just screw back.
Nah.
Off of the bud.
Well, okay. I meant for you and I.
Yeah, well, this is a big moment.
Here we have Muzz, the ever fading in weight Muzz. Walking up here. That's missed by a kilometre.
He missed by a... It could be alright here though.
How's Vinny's doubles?
Vinny loves the safety. Gee.
Is he doubling this?
Well,
he's playing safe.
That's a good shot.
Relatively, it's a good shot.
I reckon the bud could clip this though. Reckon the nine is hard on the rail. But he needs to do is pull the bottom right. Go for a risk.
Alright, gentlemen, what does he do here?
Well, he's playing.
Well, if I was him,
has he called it?
I'll go for the corner pocket. He's just got to avoid for the in off.
He's going for the corner pocket, is he?
Yeah.
Yeah, hips to left. Hips
to
right.
It's an easy shot.
In off up the top. If he pots it, I think. I don't have to worry about this. Yeah. He's about to launch that too. He was about to launch that one off the table.
Not happy.
You remember that Dan's filming this match, so he didn't want to have that on camera.
He's going to be our first player on the hill here.
Yeah, there you go.
He's not excited about that.
He's not a happy bud at the moment.
He's not a happy bud.
No.
That's a good expression.
Buddy, not happy.
He was in front of 6 and just lost 4 in a row.
Yep. Well, Vinny's in Vinny mode now. He's been making some really good pots.
Both players, I would just say both players, played exceptionally this week.
Yeah. They rise to the occasion, that's for sure.
They always do, these
two. Especially Vinny in the semi-final being 6-1 down.
Yeah, he was ridiculously good.
Yeah, Jason Armand made the semi and Riley
Jason
in the other
Armand
semi.
Very, very well.
He had a couple He played a couple of bunnies first off today, but he fired up after that.
Thanks a lot, mate.
No, I'm just joking, much. Brother. I love you, Baz.
The mule?
Okay, come on, bud.
Oh,
no,
he's done it again.
And he's just broken and got... Look, if that two goes in as well, he's potted 8 balls.
That's in a row.
Potted 8 balls.
Hello.
Well, I think...
Okay, this big chance of being real... Oh, no, the one stayed up, so he has to play...
1-3 is not easy.
If you get 1 and 3 go in, I'd say that's all over.
At least it's the next ball.
If he stop shot, 3...
Right there. Yeah.
Can land
plumb
on the
3
and
look
for the
3
on the bottom left.
That's
an
easy shot.
You should bloody move it.
He's
in the zone.
He's
thinking. Land high on the 4.
A new Timbul Oceania champion here.
I don't know
folks.
About that. I don't know about that one. That might be the wrong side.
On the wrong side of the 4.
Don't worry. Vinny's done lots of spinny shots in his time to get on here.
A little bit of check. No,
yeah.
He's not on it.
He's
not.
He's going to keep rolling.
He's on it.
Yeah, that's strong.
He's going to keep rolling.
But this is...
It's not easy. He's going to have to use the jigger, and it's very thin.
I can sense the in-off here.
You can sense an in-off?
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. Oh.
Oh, my God.
Tell you what, Walker, that's you've nearly had the call of the century.
Yeah.
He's nearly gone off in the middle and the corner.
He hit that very well, though. Yeah, just looking at the camera. How are you doing?
Smiling over there, which,
yeah. Dead weight. Cool. Snooker himself. Perfect.
Oh, it's helped him. If that's on.
Controversial, folks.
Oh,
it's
on.
Controversial.
Oh, that has got him. The Magic Rex made a roll in.
Oh.
No, it wasn't on. Okay.
Well, he could have took his time and thought about the shot more.
It's one of those 50-yard line shots.
Yeah. That's an open pocket shot.
Big shot here from the
top. And he's gone in off too. And he's potted the nine.
Yeah.
Handshake comes. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for watching. Thanks to Alec again for having us. Thanks, Walker. Thanks, Barry, you handsome devil, for commentating. It's been good fun.
Thank you very much, Dan Lynch, for letting me commentate today.
Yeah, thanks, Dan, for bringing all your gear here.
No worries. Thank you, Kubo TV.
Thank you, obviously, last and foremost, to the guys out there watching.
And all the people that travelled to play.
Till next time, guys.
Thank you.
Cheers to Empire.
Thanks, guys. Just want to congratulate Vinny for a great match there, and Sean Bard, unlucky Sean.
Thank you.